Hi guys, I am Erica. I am here to discuss the 10 topics about the fundamentals and business analytics. I hope this video will help you guys. Let's start. The first topic that I will be going to discuss is the business function. Business functions are processes and operations that ensure the proper functioning of an organization. In general, startups and small companies employ people who can perform several functions rather than hiring specialists. There are 4 types of business functions. The first 2 are sales and marketing. They are the ones who are responsible for researching the market and your target audience, monitoring the company's image on social media, creating advertising campaigns, and acquiring new customers. Some examples of these are brochures and other promotional materials. The third function is the human resource management. They are the ones who are responsible for attracting talent, screening potential candidates, managing employees' relations, and maintaining optimum working conditions. The next function is accounting and finance. As a small business owner, you may outsource accounting or handle this task on your own. If you plan to hire employees or expand your operations, getting professional is a must. In this case, it's worth setting up an accounting and finance department. The last function is the operation and production. It's defined as the process which transforms the inputs or resources of an organization into final goods or services. Through a set of defined, controlled, and repeatable policies, we refer to the rules that add value to the final output. The second topic is the business process. Business process is a set of activities that can accomplish a specific organizational goal. It should have purposely goals, be as specific as possible, and have consistent outcomes. One example of this is the process of making products to sell in the market, such as by the use of manpower or by the use of new technology. The next topic that I will be going to discuss is the 5 M's in the business. The first component in the 5 M's is the manpower. Manpower is the most important component in the business. Putting the right personnel for the right position is a sure bet for organizational effectiveness and efficiency. Because if there is no man to operate the machineries and a man to handle the money, there is no process that will be working on organization and enterprises. The second to the most important components in the business is money. Without money, no venture or enterprise can motivate workers, get quality and sufficient materials, get the right machine and maintain them, or even ensure that time is properly managed. If there is no money, the organization cannot pay the employees, as well as no money can buy the materials. The third component is method. Every product has a process or multiple processes that it must go through before it is ready to be delivered. As a final product to a customer, the methods used to perform value-added work to the product must be consistent and controlled. The machine should verify that each process took place properly and that each part or assembly being processed is correct. or meets the quality specification of the part. The business is planning the overall process that they will performing to attain their goal. Starting from the brainstorming on how the plan will going to work up to the implementation of the process. Materials is next on the list. Materials are the resources used by a company to produce finished goods and products. Without materials, human resource is made redundant, and the production of product is not possible. The last M is machinery. The metal contraption called machines had made man fulfill almost effortless various dreams of creating things that make our existence more worthwhile. Machines help the manpower be more easy and fast. This will help to produce more product that will be selling to the market. Let's proceed to the fourth topic, which is the information system. Information system, or IS, refers to a collection of multiple pieces of equipment involved in the collection, processing, storage, and dissemination of information. There are some examples of information systems. These are the hardware, software, computer system connections and information system users, and the system housing are all part of an IS, such as personal computers and smartphones. Let's proceed to the types of information systems. Transaction processing systems are operational level systems at the bottom of the pyramid. They are usually operated directly by shop floor workers or frontline staff, which provide the key data required to support the management of operations. This data is usually obtained through the automated or semi-automated tracking of low-level activities and basic transactions. Some examples of transaction processing systems are payroll systems, order processing systems, reservation systems, stock control systems, and systems for payments and funds transfers. Management information systems are management level systems that are used by middle managers to help ensure the smooth running of the organization in the short to medium term. The highly structured information provided by these systems allows managers to evaluate an organization's performance by comparing current with previous outputs. Some examples of management information systems are sales management systems, inventory control systems, budgeting systems, management reporting systems, and personnel systems. Decision support system can be seen as a knowledge-based system used by senior managers, which facilitates the creation of knowledge and allow its integration into the organization. These systems are often used to analyze existing structured information and allow managers to project the potential effects of their decision into the future. Such systems are usually interactive and are used to solve ill-structured problems. Some examples of decision support systems are group decision support systems, computer-supported cooperative work, logistic systems, financial planning systems, and spreadsheet models. Electronic commerce, or e-commerce, is a business model that lets firms and individuals to buy and sell things over the internet. Some example of these are Amazon, Lazada, Shopee, and Zalora. Let's talk about the different e-commerce business model. Business to consumer is the first type of e-commerce. It is also the most common one among the three. It works by retailers and marketers that use clear data in various marketing tools so can sell their products to the internet users. The internet users can use the shopping cart for everything they need. Payment is mostly done through credit cards or by payment gateways like the PayPal. Business-to-business model is the largest e-commerce model that is based on revenue, which involves trillions of dollars. Both the buyers and sellers are business entities. Business-to-business describe commerce transaction between businesses, such as between a manufacturer and a wholesaler, or between a wholesaler and a retailer. C2C model involves electronically facilitated transactions between consumers through some third party. A common example of this is the online auction, in which a consumer posts an item for sale and other consumers bid to purchase it.
What is database? Database is a collection of data or information that is specially organized for rapid search and retrieval by a computer. These are the some examples of databases. Thank you for watching.